This clip is from the City of Gainesville public meeting on February the 18th, featuring scathing comments directed at local party Democrat leaders from Minority District 1 City Commissioner Charles Gostin. Following this are comments from former Mayor Mark Goldstein, who demanded an apology from Democrat Party leaders with a threat to quit the party if no apology was forthcoming within 30 days. Ed Braddy is challenged for re-election to mayor of Gainesville in an officially nonpartisan race by the local Democratic Party favorite, Lauren Poe, whose campaign was so weak that the state Democratic Party was asked to provide highly controversial smut flyers in an effort to rescue his campaign. The flashpoint of outrage was sparked by what many regard as a racist campaign flyer that uses a tasteless minstrel show of anonymous black faces to wallpaper a vicious attack against Mayor Braddy. The flyers were mailed to mostly African-American District 1 voters as an electioneering communication paid for by the Florida Democratic Party in Tallahassee, a desperate campaign tactic that incensed many local party loyals. Under pressure from party leaders, District 1 voters have historically followed lockstep instructions from party bosses, even when it was clear to others the vote may not be in their best economic interests. Lauren Poe's unapologetic vote for a $30 billion biomass power purchase agreement while serving on a previous city commission lies at the heart of his campaign weakness.
Mayor, Commissioners, I'm Debbie Martinez. I would like to show you exactly how the DEC machine party bosses are trying to pervert our community with yet another desperate round of their political pornography. Overhead, please.
Overhead, please.
Tea Partier Mayor Ed Braddy is embarrassing and expensive. Boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Commissioner Gostin.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. I want to comment on the flyers that came out, you know, as an elected official. And I can say it because, you know, I went through it. And it's a shame when you have, and especially me as an African-American, and I'm speaking from this perspective, when you have your own people that look just like you, who are just as vicious as they can be, okay? And they know the circumstances that we face. They are a part of the organizations that stand in the way of what you're trying to do, the improvements that you're trying to make. And that's what makes it painful for me, because they would rather see a whole lot of nothing than to see somebody stand up and fight for them that have never been fought for in the last 60 years. And that's what they did to me. One of my campaign managers is sitting out there in the audience. And I can say this with all honesty, that I told him that one thing that we're not going to do, and we don't have to do it, we don't have to get indignant, we don't have to throw any slime, and we don't have to spend our money telling lies on the other person. Because I felt like the qualities that I possessed was enough to beat whoever I was running against. And I tell people all the time, I didn't just beat anybody. I beat a two-time incumbent. And then I came back in the runoff and beat the incumbent. Never had to do anything nasty like they did to the mayor. But it's always the same people every single time. Same characters, all right? And we sit back and act as if we don't know who they are. They did it to Barbara Shaw. And Barbara was nothing but a good school board representative. They did it to Bonnie Burgess when she ran for school board. They did it to Annie Orlando, okay? They did it to a whole lot of other people, the same characters. We know who they are, but we still seem to want to accept them when they come around us like, you didn't do a thing. When we had to spend money for an attorney, and I want you to listen closely at this. We had to spend money, myself, Barbara Shaw, Juanita Hamilton, Irwin Owens, to go before the Judicial Committee, because the DEC wrote a letter, because we stood up for Ed Braddy on the corner in front of Walmart, And he lied on me and said, well, he had on an Ed Braddy shirt. I had on a Florida A&M shirt. And how do you confuse Ed Braddy with FAMU? How do you do it? But we had to hire a lawyer. These DEC people sent one letter to whom it may concern, not even to the chair. And in 2 weeks, we had to go before a judicial committee. Okay? Pay lawyer fees. Got there. They found out that we weren't even members of the DEC, but it didn't matter. But what Barbara Sharp said, no, let me take that back. What the Honorable Barbara Sharp said a few minutes ago sang volumes to me. Because one thing, as being a Democrat, and I've been one ever since I came out of the military, is this. If you're an African American, they only want you when they want to use you. I could not call the FDP office and get anything. Even as an elected official, I can say, why don't you investigate this? Why don't you do that? Never get a response. But you can get those people over in the DEC, Evelyn Fox and the rest of them, Terry Fleming, the rest of them, pick up the phone, call FDP, what do you want? And some people say, well, he's exaggerating. No, I'm not. Sherwin Henry ran for mayor. Didn't get a dime from the FDP. Didn't get a dime from the DEC. But the FDP sure sent his opponent $25,000, but no problem. Okay? And see, we had to go over there and confront the DEC to get them to even give Sherwin what they gave. And we got an opponent back here. He's running. He's a Democrat. They don't like him, so he don't qualify. And I'm telling you, I can say this because I experienced it, and I came through it. And when I see people get up to the, you know, the mic and have this to say and that to say, I'm saying, really? You got to live this stuff, okay? And when you start talking about tragedy, the tragedy of this whole thing is that the qualifications of the best candidates get lost in the translation. You know, that's the sin. Is that the best candidate will never, ever be revealed for all the dirty stuff and all the lies they go out in the street and tell. Okay? So my emphasis is this. As a victim, and a recovered victim, okay, and so is Ms. Sharp, and so is Juanita Hamilton and everybody else, the DEC is responsible right today of the Alachua County Democratic Black Caucus charter being suspended for no reason. They are. Nobody else. So if you want to believe that there's no machine, be my guest. If you want to believe that these people are not in your best interest, go ahead. But I tell you what, when we get beyond one black on the school board, when we get beyond one black on the county commission, when we get beyond one black on the city commission, then I can say with all sincerity, we are beyond it. But until that happens, what you see is what you get. Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you for your comments.
Mayor, commissioners, my name is Mark Goldstein. I came down tonight because of something that's been going on that concerns me, and I'd like the commission to take notice and let the word go out. Somehow or other, it has become politically acceptable to divide our community into communities that are not divided. I've always regarded, both as a mayor and a commissioner, that we have one community and we care for each other. Always lived in the inner city, always cared about the people next to me. I know you all feel the same way. I do expect corporations from up north, like Hatchet Creek, to come in and try to make promises and try to change the political structure. I expect Plum Creek to do the same thing. That's about money. But they got the wrong idea. We're not two cities. We're one. We're not two colors. We're one. We are a community that cares for each other. So when a party that I happen to belong to tries to exploit that difference, it's beyond my comprehension. And I'm not sure what to do about it, except to bring the attention, your attention to it. And it's not about you, Mr. Mayor, and it's not about anybody here. It's about a party that believes they understand this community. They do not. We are one. We care for each other. We always have. Let the word go out from this forum, from this special place, from this place where the people get a chance to talk, that we're one community, and that using special attempts to undermine us because of a need to win an election, and I've won some and I've lost some, but I have always honored both my opponents and the community that voted for them and for me. Let the word go out that we're one community, and no matter what corporation or what party, we reject the assumptions that are made and the abuses that we're put to for that reason. And had I not come down and said it tonight, I'd be uncomfortable. I don't mind being number 189 of Plum Creek tonight, but this comes first. This is about who we are, and I don't want other people telling us who we are, including parties from Savannah or from Atlanta. I've been a member of the party, for Democratic Party, for many, many years, and until I hear an apology within 30 days, I won't be after 50 or 60 years of being a member. I think we need an apology, and I think we need the word to go out as to who we are, and I think you all need to say so, too, and I know you will. Thank you very much for the attention.
Thank you for your comments.
A week later, on February the 24th, the Alachua County Democrats had still not issued an apology for the offensive Democratic Party campaign flyer. Let's not reward the bullying tactics of a political party attack in a nonpartisan city election. Don't end up in the Poe House. Re-elect Ed Braddy for mayor of Gainesville.